and cast the demon over the angels of God. That in the name of Jesus, every diviner, every witchcraft, every spell, every hexes, in the name of Jesus, I pass it to be the fall and die. It's a decree. Nothing changes it. The path of the righteous has a shining light. It's shining more to the perfect day. Your path shall shine with light. Your path shall shine. I pass a decree that light will shine upon your path. I pass a decree in the name of Jesus. Let the light of God shine upon your path. You will no longer walk in darkness. A prince is a royal son of a king.
Amen.
As a prince.
Thank you, Lord.
And the same thing with the princess. Princes are served. Princesses are served. Before she stand up and walk, two or three people will gather and follow her. That is how it is with you.
Amen.
In the spirit world, there is nowhere you went without angels following. This is what Master Jesus did. In the path of God justice, he told the Lord, he said, by my blood, I make them princes. You want to go to the stream to bath alone, angels are following. And they are watching while you are swimming in the stream. But because some of you don't see, everything is physical. No, no, no. Somebody said, no. The spirit control the physical.
Amen.
Can I have a good evening?
Amen.
God Almighty is the King of Kings, and you are made his son.
Amen.
How? Ask yourself how. As I'm speaking now, some people don't believe that they are sons of God.
Yes, that's right. Amen.
I said, no. Do you believe in God? Yes. Do you believe you are a son of God? Ah, no.
Uh-oh.
I know my papa. My papa, I'm from Nigeria. Apostle, don't you know I'm from Jamaica? My papa is from Kingston. No, I cancel that for you.
Amen.
Apostle, you don't even know that I'm from Guyana. No, I cancel it for you. You have made a change. There is a change in your destiny. There is a change in your area. There is a change in your country. There is a change. You are now a son, a prince, and a princess of the kingdom of heaven. When you pass a decree, heaven must open. You better enlarge your course quickly. So that this commission can really get to where it's going.
Amen.
I keep pouring this in on you.
Amen.
God will be tired of you.
Thank you, Jesus.
It is all because you believe Jesus.
Amen.
And it's all because you believe that Jesus is the anointed one. Somebody lift up your hand and say, Jesus is the anointed one.
Jesus is the anointed one.
Anytime you wake up in the morning and you greet the Lord and say, Lord Jesus, I pronounce with my mouth because I believe in my heart, you are the anointed one.
Yes, Lord. Hallelujah.
You know what happens? Instantly, you are moved into the crown royal son of God. That's what the Bible says in 1 John chapter 5, verse 1. It says, whosoever believeth Jesus Christ is born of God, and everyone that loveth him becomes the son of God.
Thank you, Lord.
He that is born of the Spirit is Spirit. You believe that Jesus is son of God, but nothing is happening in your life. Because your confession is fake. The heart don't agree with your confession. I've told you there is something we call synchrosystem. Synchrosystem. When your heart agrees with what your mouth says, when your mouth agrees with what your heart is received, nothing can change your confession.
Amen.
It must come to pass.
Amen.
Don't just be making confession until you believe first in your heart that what you are about to confess will come to pass.
Amen.
The Holy Spirit came to make you, my friend, and he came to make you a prince or a princess who rules in this world. And in the midst of his enemies, you are to rule. To rule and to reign. In Psalm 66 verse 3, the Bible says, say unto God, how terrible art thou in thy works, through the greatness of thy power, shall thy enemies submit themselves unto thee. Submission, they must submit. How many enemies carry your money? How many of them carry your house? How many of them are holding your car now, as I'm talking right now? And the Bible says, if this word of God is true, as you believe that word of God is true, then the enemy is supposed to submit what belongs to you. Come on, somebody shout it out. That's why I taught you a heavy, 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 greatest dominion prayer.
Amen.
And I told you, when you confront them, split the blood, and say, I plead the blood against you.
Yes.
Now submit yourself to me and be controlled.
Thank you, Lord.
Anybody carrying weapon against you, you don't go for the truth of that person. You go for the weapon. Don't be foolish about it. I'm going for the juggler. You will just press the trigger. You don't go for any juggler. Don't wrestle with a man with gun. If it is kicking or something, you do, pow, cut off the weapon from his hand.
Amen.
Damn! You cannot remember to go for the juggler. There was a time I used to practice taekwondo. Yeah, I did it for almost a year. I was always on the tatami. They would teach me how to use the jaguar claw and how to do this, how to do that. The only thing that I succeeded to learn how to do, because I discovered that the jaguar claw don't work. I'm serious. And you get it, you do this, you say you want to carry somebody, they will shoot you. But when you have grace,
amen,
and you take, there's something we call hammer lock, which I learned when I was doing taekwondo. You just move as if you are passing the person, and once your shoulder is on the shoulder, you lock him like this, on the neck, and you let go like this, and that's it. It's called hammer lock. You can do it to the fast. You can do it to the most powerful man in the world. It's going down.
Amen.
I don't use juggler. You just break your juggler claw. But do it is wisdom of God. Do I say, oh boy, I don't have power to fight you. And you stand once you get there. Tighten your hand on that. Put your leg like this. Go, ah! It's going down, my friend. In the military, you know, when we're in the military, you must fight. It's a must. You have to fight. You do boxing and you will do MMA.
Amen.
Amen. So they put me with one guy. Oh my God. In the boxing, the guy beats. He beats the crap off me. My coach was shouting. He said, hey, jab, jab. I said, jab what? 3 minutes was like 30 hours. I said, oh my God. I was trying to jab. Then my coach said, okay, I know what is your problem. You lack stamina. So he said, I should go and do stamina. Okay, I began to do stamina. But I said, I'm not going to that ring again. But when it comes to MMA, I didn't practice all the. They will teach you how to fight. They'll tell you what to do. You know, because in our own is combat, how you will be able to wrestle and get somebody. You know, the gun they used before has knife, right? So we are taught how to get that knife out so that the knife is meant to kill. On face-to-face battle, you don't shoot the enemy, you use that knife. So they teach us all those things. When they taught all those things, they put me inside the tatami, inside the mat with this guy. And my house, you know, it's house to house. So my house was shouting, they were rooting. They said, you missed the boxing, you got to do this. You got to, oh God. When the guy started, he was doing all those kicking, he was doing, hey, do this. I didn't say anything, I just did like this. Because I've learned that one before, I couldn't do it. I just stood there. Put my leg there. You know that? Oh, I said, go down, my friend. Go down there now. Submit on the defeated. And the guy went down. So everybody in my house shouted. I said, yes, I've won. And I did like this. But I know that the race is not for the swift. The guy could have beaten me again. He could have beaten the crap off me again. If not for the ability that God gave me. Somebody shout glory. So my friends, this is the dominion of the King of Heaven. And this is what we got to live in. Whoever he chooses, he make them to sit among princes. In the book of 1 Samuel chapter 2, verse 8, we saw what happened to Hannah. Hannah was living in barrenness. Hannah was living in pain. Every time she sleep with her husband, the pregnancy would not come. Every time she make love, the pregnancy would not come. And her sister was against her. The other wife was insulting her. Every day, Hannah was troubled. She was worried. She needed a child. No child was coming. One day, she went down to Shiloh and she began to pray a dangerous prayer. A prayer that moved the heaven. A prayer that told the heaven, I am a princess. I am made to have this child. I am not a slave. All the barrenness, I break the yoke of barrenness because of the grace of God. I come from the tribe of Abraham.
Amen.
And God had him for a prayer. And immediately she had a prayer. She had that baby. Look at what she said. She said, Lord God, you are the one that raised the poor out of the dunghill. And you lifted them to sit among princes. Today, in the name of Jesus, by the blood of Jesus, I stand to decree. I pass a decree over everyone here in the spirit world. And I say, in the name of Jesus, you are now lifted from the dunghill. You are lifted and you shall sit among the princes. If you're receiving this letter, come to you faster. You shall sit among the princes now, because God declared you to be a princess. God declared you to be a prince. You are a prince. You are not a slave. You are a prince. You are a prince. You are a prince. Rule with money. Because you are precious.
Amen.
Blood of Jesus is a precious blood.
Amen.
Make you precious before the Lord.
Amen.
Somebody shout glory.
Glory.
This is the story of Jacob. And I'll close now. Somebody ready?
Amen.
Jacob was a supplanter. Amen. In fact, the name means supplanter. The word supplanter means deceiver. So Jacob was a deceiver. We saw how he deceived his brother Esau. Even when he was being born,
yeah.
He deceived his brother.
Yeah.
He held the leg of his brother as he was coming in. Yeah. And again, we saw how Jacob went into the house of Laban. Mm-hmm. And he used that deception also to begin to walk.
Amen.
But God knew the story, original history, and original person who Jacob was.
Mm-hmm.
One day, God himself came down and said, I have to change this guy. I have to change who he is. Many talk about a change of name, but I come to tell you it's a change of spirit. It's a change of spirit, my brother and my sister. When there is a change in your spirit name, there is a renewal, the right spirit within me. When your spirit is wrong, you will be seeing wrong things. And so always ask the Lord. And the right spirit is the Holy Spirit. The spirit that will take you out of slavery.
Amen.
God knew for sure that Jacob, the way he was going to lose completely. Because God is not going to use a deceiver.
Amen.
And God has purposed Jacob to be a prince.
Amen.
tell you, my brother, my sister, when he encountered God, he wrestled with the Bible says he wrestled with God, but I come to tell you the revelation that God gave me. Because I asked the Lord, I said, who can wrestle with God and survive? Who can ever wrestle with God and still stand?
Amen.
And God said, that one wrestled his faith. Let me tell you this, and I want you to listen. Your faith can move God.
Amen.
That's what happened.
Amen.
Your faith can move mountain and it can move God.
Amen.
God is moved by your faith.
Amen.
Death was pronounced on Isaac. When God saw the faith of Abraham, he turned that death into life.
Amen.
The woman of the issue of blood. For 12 years she was bleeding, losing life. When God saw her faith, that this is dried up. The one wrestling with God is someone who has faith and wrap God with his faith. Wrap God with your faith and say, Father, Abba, Father, this is my faith. You saw that every miracle Jesus did, he was always telling them, by your faith. By your faith. Somebody will be in certain condition, and once they come and realize who Christ is, it shall come on that day when the burden shall be lifted off your shoulder. And the yoke shall be destroyed from off your neck because of the anointing. Jesus is the anointed one. Anointed to deliver you. Anointed to heal you. Anointed to make you righteous. Anointed to make you a millionaire. We know the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ. Even though he was rich yet for your sakes, he became poor that through his poverty you may be rich. Jesus was anointed for you.
Amen.
He was anointed for you.
Amen.
So when you see and release your faith in that anointing, not that you see and encounter with Jesus anointing and you still see them the same way. Every day God is throwing it at you and you say it's not to be taken. Even right now. A prince is born here tonight.
Amen.
That's what is happening. A prince is born in the atmosphere tonight.
Amen.
A prince that will no longer live in the valley.
Amen.
A prince that will no longer be remembered as a deceiver.
Amen.
A prince that will no longer be remembered as one that is eating from nothing. But a prince that is to be served. A prince that is to be served. A prince that everyone will look and see the record power upon this prince and say, yes, a true prince has come. And it is time to bow to a prince. A prince. So this Jacob wrestled with God. And I told you that wrestling means faith. Amen?
Amen.
The word I said, the word wrestling is that he releases faith to God and he won. Anytime you release your faith to God, you will win.
Amen.
Amen.
Hezekiah, God sent prophet Isaiah. He said, go tell him he's going to die.
Yes.
He's going to die. When God said it, nobody can change it. The only thing that can stop any disaster and judgment of God in your life is faith.
Amen.
I wonder whether I could have a better amen.
Amen.
That's the greatest word you ever have.
Amen.
You can change judgment by your faith.
Amen.
Poverty is judgment.
Yes.
Lack is judgment.
Amen.
Any dry thing in your life is judgment. Yes. For you not to have is judgment. Yes. The enemy is judging you.
Yes.
Slapping with the blood and telling that baby, you are not put out for that judgment. Because mercy has overcome judgment.
Amen.
He won. God revealed to him his original plan. Listen. I'm going to preach this message again in a different, on a higher level on Sunday by the grace of God. Let him give us grace.
Amen.
We'll receive grace for it.
Amen.
What do princes do? What does a prince or a princess do? Naturally, I am born a prince. Naturally. I don't claim it because I'm higher. The spirit. So
amen.
I prefer the spirit one.
Amen.
But as a prince in your father's compound in Africa, they will teach you how to pass decrees. When you are small like this, as you see all these boys, I'm teaching them how to pass decree. Some of them that are not, that are really, really, that I see that yes, and especially those of you that love your children and bring them close. Your children, especially the male one, they need the touch of a prince.
Amen.
Let me tell you one thing that I don't say. Not every father realizes that he's a prince.
Amen.
Ask OJ. If he will tell you the truth, he will tell you that his life is changing since he connected to me.
Amen.
You cannot connect to a prince and a medicine.
Amen.
Your life must change.
Amen.
It could be gradual, but ultimately it will change.
Amen.
When I get to Nigeria, I rule like a prince.
Amen.
You know? All this what you're doing here, I just look at you, I have value things. I pass decree.
Amen.
You don't come to me anyhow. I don't struggle to enter a car. No? Cars are lined up,
yes.
Open with the driver at the seat.
Yes, Lord.
That is the way it is for me. I want you to understand that I stayed in America because God says so.
Amen.
Not because there's anything there.
Amen.
That's how I pass decrees. And when I pass a decree, anything that goes against the decree perish.
Jesus.
Oh yes. I release the same anointing upon you. I release the same anointing upon you. I pass that glory upon your heads. This is decree justice. The past decrees. A decree is an authoritative word that cannot be changed. You cannot pass a decree until you are in dominion first. You can't be begging and be decreeing.
Amen.
If you want to pass a decree, you must cut out begging first.
Amen.
I've never seen a true king who begs.
Amen.
Come and tell his subjects and say, I'm begging you now, please. Don't listen to that king. What kind of king is that? Did you look at King David and look at Israel and say, Israel, please, I'm begging you. No. You just sign and pass a decree. Every one of you do this. Yes, sir. The king has spoken.
Amen.
The presidential system of government has deafened some of you. So you have allowed the society to turn you upside down. I'm here to turn you back to your glory.
Amen.
You are not what they say you are.
Amen.
You are a prince and a princess.
Amen.
You are meant to pass decrees.
Amen.
You are meant to be served.
Amen.
Not to beg. The cross is over.
Amen.
The sin is over.
Yes.
A righteousness has come.
Yes.
If righteousness came, you must live and rule in righteousness.
Yes.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Okay. Open to Job 22 for me. I'm going to close now. Are you excited?
Amen.
With what?
Amen.
Those of you that are here, let me tell you something. If you want to help people, help them, but make sure that you help people on the righteous end.
Amen.
Let me tell you something. You can make a man to become poor forever.
Amen.
If you are not careful. I have a younger brother. His name is Ibrahim. Very intelligent boy. My younger brother don't just want to walk. He knows him. He doesn't want to walk.